One day, Matt is riding his skateboard when he crashes and falls, hitting his head. Matt's brain collides with his skull, stretching and tearing some of his brain tissue. Matt has sustained a concussion. Concussions are also called mild traumatic brain injuries. You might be wondering, how do these types of injuries occur? Normally, your brain is suspended in a cushioning liquid called cerebrospinal fluid. This fluid allows your brain to stay put, even as your body moves. But the high force impacts associated with a concussion overwhelm the protection provided by this special fluid. Think about the brain as a very fast computer that runs your body. Just like computers, the brain needs a well-controlled and stable environment. The blood-brain barrier creates and maintains this environment. The blood-brain barrier is made up of blood vessels surrounded by astrocytes and neurons. This barrier is the brain's gatekeeper and controls what gets into or comes out of the brain to ensure that brain cells stay happy. It also provides essential nutrients to all brain cells. When a concussion occurs, some neurons and astrocytes get stretched and twisted. Most importantly, some blood vessels break, allowing molecules that aren't supposed to be in the brain to get inside. These molecules upset neurons and astrocytes. The cells ask for help from the rest of the body by sending out chemical distress signals called biomarkers. Researchers use specialized lab equipment to measure biomarkers in a patient's blood or saliva. Two such blood biomarkers have recently been approved by the FDA for clinical use, and hopefully, doctors will be able to use these biomarkers to diagnose concussions. However, until this new blood test is readily available, doctors still need to make a diagnosis by examining patients and asking them, as well as their family and friends, a long list of questions about the patient's physical, cognitive, and behavioral symptoms. Now we know what happens inside your brain. But what does this mean for Matt? Matt's brain needs complete rest, meaning no TV, no computer time, and no strenuous activity. Even though he may not be able to see the harm done to his brain, like he could with a broken arm, brain injuries are serious medical conditions. What started out as a concussion could become a larger problem later in life if Matt doesn't take the appropriate time to recover.